Being the Oilers' tough guy wasn't always fun either. It was a good time playing with Wayne Gretzky. But Semenko is remembered more for protecting his teammates than setting them up for goals. Some of Semenko's most intense battles were against the Flames, and he got used to being booed at the Saddle Dome.
It was just something that expected the players, that the culprits that they had here with Tim Hunter and Jim Poplinski, they were getting the same treatment at Edmonton, so it just goes with the territory.
Semenko's territory changed in 1986. He was traded by the Oilers to Hartford, but he didn't last long there, and he ended up with the Leafs. They had a coach, though, that wanted Semenko to forget all about hockey and concentrate on being a goon.
John Brophy was an aggressive type of coach. He liked that style, but he wanted me just for one reason only, and it wasn't to play hockey.
So Semenko decided it was time to quit, but he had a lot of trouble adjusting to life after hockey.
I really didn't have any preparation for retirement. I took almost a year off.
Semenko had a few ideas. He wrote a book, tried real estate, but nothing seemed to fill the void left by hockey. More and more, Semenko got involved in the party scene. He was always a guy who liked to drink, but in retirement, he was losing control.
I didn't have a coach that was watching me every day. I didn't have a job where I had to be there all the time, so my motivation to work was very low, and I didn't have to show up, so it was very easy not to do anything. But I realized it was time to straighten my life out, and the Oilers came the aid. They sent me to the Betty Ford Center to straighten myself out, and it's been great since.